they're getting closer and closer together. Not too long ago, they were like that. Now they're like that. They came in like this, boom, 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 night after night. And the next few nights, they will get like that. And that's why I keep coming out here, shooting the video. Never mind that the fireworks are going to start in 4 minutes, 5 minutes. It's so early, these weekday fireworks, that there's still a touch of sunlight in the sky. Not enough to light up my face, though. The dog likes it. The doggy likes it. Yeah, she does. There they are, two planets. They seem to be getting very close, but that's just because if you drew a straight line from here, one would pass through one and almost pass through the other. And meanwhile, back on the Earth, time for the Blackfish fireworks. 7 miles away in the distance, kaboom. There, only now you can hear the explosions. Almost a whole minute after it flashed. Well, 35, 40 seconds. Sure is bright. But like I said, that's not why I'm out here tonight. I'm out here to look at the planets. Flashing away out there in the west, next to SeaWorld, home of the great Blackfish. Oh yes, you see, there's the city right there, and off there in the distance are them fireworks. You know, I really should learn just how to let the camera be still. I hate it when I'm looking at videos and it's jerking all over everywhere. But we keep trying to make it perfect, and we end up with jumpy, jaggedy, jingly, knocked about, unstable camera. It's been a long time since I went to SeaWorld. Let's see. Many years ago, I decided I didn't want to go there anymore. I didn't like the way they were holding those intelligent dolphins prisoner, turning them into carnival freak shows, making money off of them. But I did go twice. It's been 20 or 30 years ago that I went. The last two times I went, both times were free. One time was when I was working for the city of San Diego in the special events office. There was a big whoop-de-doo to promote the latest Chamber of Commerce something or another, convention or something or another, tourist something or another. I keep forgetting. There was this group. I've forgotten their name now. It's been so long. But they put on a big show at SeaWorld to introduce their latest commercial tourism campaign to get people to come to San Diego. I remember the guy who was the head of the Convention and Visitors Bureau, that's what it was called. His last name was Reindeers, except it was pronounced Reinders. And his first name was Reint, except it was pronounced Rein. So I remember seeing his name, I went, Reint, Reindeers. And then my boss said, no, no, no. His name is Reint Reinders. Pretty important guy around town. I don't follow those things anymore. It's been a long time. I went to Mexico and lived there for 10 years, and now I've been living back over here for 10 years, just taking care of my mom. Looks like the fireworks are over. That little blue thing down in the lower left is the tower. Fall triangle of lights hanging on strings from it. When the fireworks are over, they light it up. So we're gonna go back over to the real reason I'm out here. Venus and Jupiter. So I went to the Blackfish Park. My God, that must have been 1995. Yeah, I left the city in 96, 97. Went back to the university for a year or two and then moved to Tijuana in 1999. But I had been a few years before, again, free. I hadn't been going for years already. By then, it had been 10 or 15 years. But sometime around 1986, my cousin married a guy whose daughter worked at SeaWorld, and she worked with the penguins. And they got my son and I, he was like 5, 6 years old at the time, and she invited my son and I to come backstage and see the penguins. And we did that. We didn't spend much time at SeaWorld because we just wanted to see the penguins. And that and the special Convention and Visitors Bureau show 10 years later, it was the last time I ever went to SeaWorld. Both times I went only because it was free. So I could say I didn't spend my money on them. It's, you know, people say, well, if you don't like SeaWorld keeping the whales in tanks, well, how can you support the zoo? Well, because some of the animals in the zoo now actually are endangered, threatened. And the zoo does a lot of work on their wildlife habitat to try to save them, save their habitat. And it's true, the animals are on display. I can't get this damn thing to focus. It's very true. The animals in the zoo are on display. But they do a lot of work preserving endangered species. Now, SeaWorld, I'll use their proper name because I'm going to say something good about them. They do a lot of help to animals that are trapped in oil spills and washed up sick on the shore. They have a whole program where they care for sea animals that are in danger. But I'm still opposed to keeping killer whales and other dolphins as entertainment creatures. So that's about all I'm going to say about that, because we came out, saw the fireworks, and saw the planets, and that is that. It is Thursday. There's something in the sky over there. How interesting. My goodness. I wonder if I can identify this. Let's see now. It's right over there. Oh, now it's gone behind the tree. Well, darn. Can't show it to you because it went in the tree. Well, it didn't actually go in the tree. It's far away behind the tree. But anyway, that's all I'm going to say. Bye-bye.